In this Raspberry Pi tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can quickly image a new SD card for your Raspberry Pi. If you navigate to raspberrypi.com, then you can click on Software. They have a special Raspberry Pi OS Raspberry Pi Imager, and you can download it for your operating system. They have versions for macOS, Windows, and Linux. Just click the Download button, and then save it and install it on your computer. Once you've installed the Raspberry Pi Imager, then you can choose your Raspberry Pi device. In this case, I have a Raspberry Pi 4. You may have a different model. Choose the appropriate one. You also get a choice of which operating system to choose for your Raspberry Pi. And so you can choose the full operating system, smaller operating systems, or other general purpose or media players. These are really great for if you want to do some digital signage with your Raspberry Pi or other things like that right out of the box. I'm going to go ahead and install the full Raspberry Pi 64-bit OS. And then you get to choose the storage. I have an SD card already mounted, and I'm going to use that SD card. Then click Next on the Raspberry Pi Imager. You can actually customize the OS. So you can do things like set security keys and Wi-Fi passwords. So I'm going to click Edit Settings. It allows you to pre-fill the Wi-Fi password from your system keychain. You can go ahead and change your host name to what you want it to be. You can set a username and password, and you can also allow SSH. So this is a great way to allow you to SSH right into your Raspberry Pi on your own network right from the start without having to add a special file to your disk image. You can also use public key authentication and put your authorized keys right here. You can play a sound when finished, and you can automatically eject the media. Once you have all these things done, you go ahead and click Save. Then it asks you if you want to apply those customization settings, and you can either clear them or click Yes. And then it warns you that you're going to erase all data on your external media. Make sure you're not erasing something important. Then once it's done, it will eject the disk if you asked it to, and you can remove it from the SD card reader and put it in your Raspberry Pi and start working.